Welcome to France.
What happened here? Some questions don't have good answers.
There's a lot of soldiers out there. There's only four of us.
Find out what's inside that compound.
Aloha! This is Trinidad, the Island Man, your Island Man, coming to you live once again from beautiful Hawaii here on the island of Oahu, bringing you, yes you, the best movie reviews on the entire island of Oahu. And yes, this is Trinidad, the Island Man, your Island Man. And last night, Friday night, opening night of Overlord, the movie by J.J. Abrams, I went ahead and I saw it. And remember our rating scale, shock a thumbs up, it's good to see, I recommend it, shock a thumbs down, it's bad to see, it's junk, I don't recommend it. And for Overlord, it is a shock a thumbs up. Now let me just caveat that shock a thumbs up by saying that I would not pay 3D IMAX, if it's even showing in that, for this movie. And if you can, see it on the discount days only and or matinee. It was not really worth full price to see at nighttime or on the weekend. So definitely make full use of the discount days. Tuesday for $6 over at Regal, $7 over at Consolidated. That being said, this is the movie Overlord, and again, it is a shock a thumbs up, just barely. I think, you know, and I had to think about that, but essentially because it is one of the only war movies, World War II movies to come out, kind of in celebration of Veterans Day this coming Monday, it is a shock a thumbs up. Overall, it's a decent enough World War II story movie. If you're into the HBO movie or show, The Band of Brothers, if you liked Saving Private Ryan, you'll enjoy this movie enough. There were some older individuals in this movie. Older patrons who had gone to see this movie that were obviously veterans from World War II, and with the name Overlord, they wanted to go ahead and see it. You know, Operation Overlord was the code name used for the landing on Normandy, the Allied invasion and landing on the beach of Normandy. And that is when it takes place in this movie in World War II. A group of United States paratroopers go beyond the beaches of Normandy, as many actually did, to attempt to disable radio communications, supply lines, anti-aircraft radar, and, defense systems such as that. And that is what these group of brave soldiers do. Unfortunately, however, in the midst of it, they find and discover a Frankenstein-type lair run by the Nazis from this church that they are creating these zombie-like creatures from. Now, it was advertised, and there was a lot of hype behind this movie. When the first initial trailers came out, 6 months ago, almost a year ago, It had a lot of buzz, this movie. In the fact that, it's going to be like Call of Duty versus the zombies or something like that. And it looked really exciting. Unfortunately, the zombies, spoilers, are very, very far and few in between in this movie. I don't know what J.J. Abrams was thinking when he wrote this. But it's so disappointing. This could have been a great movie. A movie worthy of coming out on Halloween. And because the initial trailers, I was wondering why it didn't come out in October for Halloween with zombies, with the army fighting zombies. Because, one, he wanted it for Veterans Day, which I can see the impact of. And two, there are hardly any zombies in it. You get a little sprinkling of zombies, especially at the end. But overall, it's not all that. It's not what the trailers originally made it out to be. It's more of a straightforward World War II movie. Which is not a bad thing. But it just could have been that much more. It could have been that much better. And it wasn't. And for that, that will always be a missed opportunity with this movie. So that's it. That's all I got to say about it. It's like, if they had really gone full steam zombie apocalypse in World War II, this could have been a great movie. Like cult classics, like back in the 70s, a movie called, I think it was Shockwaves or something. A bunch of vacationers find an island that was an experimental lab for Nazis, and they find out that, there are these kind of mind-controlled Nazi zombie-like, soldiers on there. Or even just a couple years back on YouTube, I saw a movie from Indonesia, I believe, where it had like World War II. It was, it was set in World War II, just like this movie. The Japanese were experimenting on some type of super soldier serum for their samurai kamikaze warriors, soldiers. But then it's in the future, it's in the present day, because they were lost there, they were put into suspended animation or sleep. These vacationers, or actually they're journalists who come to explore these sites, these islands, stumble upon this and are faced to fight these Japanese World War samurai super zombie soldiers, which was a much better movie than this. And I bet J.J. Abrams saw that movie or was thinking that movie Shockwaves from all those years ago, because he's pretty old. And he was like, oh, I could do that. And for whatever reason, he copped out at the last second. He couldn't seal the deal with this movie, which would have made it so much more impressive. And this was a movie by Paramount. J.J. Abrams has some deal with Paramount. He does a lot of movies for Paramount. But DC, Warner Brothers, what is wrong with you? Why didn't you see this movie, hear of it being created by J.J. Abrams, and say, hey, we'll take that script and we'll push it forward into our DC universe? Because if John Shep was alive today from Heroes Collider, he would be saying, what? He would be saying like, sweaties, what's wrong with them, man? They should have been able to do, the Weird War from DC Comics and the G.I. Robot from this movie. And they could have, and that's what I kind of sort of expected it to be like. Because DC Comics in the 70s put out it was kind of a Sergeant Rock offshoot comic about World War II. One was the G.I. Robot, which was a robot, an American robot, that would go, fight the Japanese, the Germans, etc. And the other part was the Weird War guys, a werewolf, a vampire, and a Frankenstein-like monster working for the Allies, going back behind German enemy lines, and taking the fight to Hitler himself. That's what this movie could have been. That's what Overlord should have been, and it would have been that much more. But still, overall, for Veterans Day weekend, it is still a shock of thumbs up as a pretty cookie cutter, but decent enough, World War II veterans kind of movie. All right, thank you so much. That's Trinidad, the Island Man, your Island Man, giving Overlord a weak shock of thumbs up. Definitely see it on the discount days or matinees or Netflix and save your money from, the nighttime full price shows. All right, thank you so much and aloha.